Okay, so welcome back to the How To with Capella series. Today we were going to show you how we can use Capella as a model as a basis for an analytical study. Now, how we're going to do that is we're going to walk through this workflow that you're seeing up here. This is an operational analysis type of workflow that we're going to show. We're going to walk through the operational process depicted here. And we're going to start with kind of a configured model. You'll see here that we're going to use Jupyter Notebook as a method to do the analysis. It leverages Python, which has a lot of capabilities that we can use and tap into. The Jupyter Notebooks are going to use basically a headless version of Capella that was developed by the DB InfraGo organization, essentially the German railway, railway supporting company. This is a very active project that's been active for a few years now. There was the initial time I heard about it was back in 2021 when they published a paper at the Capella Day events. This is up on GitHub. You can go and get access to it. There actually is a binder implementation that you can launch and actually experiment with some sample models of what you can do with it. In this particular one, we're going to use the functionality around getting data values out of the model. And we're going to use that to feed simulations. So it's going to be a fun little exercise. Again, the lots of great information around installing the environment that you'll need to get this going, which is around Jupyter Notebook. And doing it. You can find that from the GitHub site for the tool set. So anyway, this is the workflow we're going to walk through. We're going to start with basically the system modeler. It's going to publish models to Git. The system model is going to be enhanced with some property information. Simulation engineer is going to go ahead and create some notebooks. And the notebook is going to have a simulation inside of it. That simulated notebook will then be created here. Once the notebook is done, it'll get published back into the Git server. We're going to run the simulation notebook, though, and get some results from it and get it operational. That notebook will access content from the system model, so it's going to get the content that it needs and use that as inputs to the simulation. And then when the simulation is done, we're going to actually publish the notebook back, again, using functionality of Jupyter Notebook and Jupyter Lab extensions. We're going to push that information back into the Git, and then we'll actually be able to take the notebook and fetch it back from the system model. We'll be able to fetch it back and run it. So we'll see all that kind of happen. So the first thing that you're going to start with is basically a system model. And the system model that you're going to have, I'm going to use a logical architecture model for this exercise. We'll go over and take a look at the logical architecture in Capella. This is an example. This is the solar power example that we all have seen before. I'm going to start with basically the sunlight and specifying how much sun we're going to get during the day. So basically, I'm going to put it at a day value. I'm going to put like 50% of the day is going to be sun. Probably a little ambitious, but just a good starting point. I'm going to talk about the solar panels. I'm going to have 2 to 4 solar panels I want to consider in the study. The solar panels wattages are around 2.5 watts. So I'm showing that here. There's going to be a charger. It's going to have a really low efficiency. It's going to be 60%. This is actually what I went through when I was doing this. I actually came up with a fairly low efficient charger because it was simple to build. There's much more higher efficiency options nowadays around this. Then I'm going to talk about battery capacity. In this case, the battery capacity is 2,800 milliamp hours we're going to choose as for the study. And then I'm going to have basically a range of batteries from 2 to 4, and we want to consider that in the study. There's going to be a boost device here that's going to basically provide current to the USB charger. The limitation on that is 2 amps. That's the most it can do. And it has a pretty good efficiency of around 90%. And then we're also going to drive from the USB device. We're going to say that it's going to be used 25% of the time during the day. And that's the max value with a nominal of 15. So we're going to use in this study just the 25%. So anyway, these properties are put on the objects. If you want to know how to put these properties on, it's fairly easy to do. What you go, you have to actually put the property on the object over here, do a add new Capella element, and add the property value to it. So here, for instance, is the property value group object that puts the object on it. Then you repeat the process to add properties. So here's a float property value, for instance. And then you can just drag the property values onto the diagram and they'll show up. So that's how easy it is to get these properties on. So anyway, I'm going to delete that one off. And so once the properties are created, what I like to do is publish to Git. So as we saw in a previous video, that's fairly simple to do, is setting up a Git implementation. You interact with the Teams functionality here, and essentially you can commit your model. Once you have Git set up, you can commit it to it, and it'll actually put the model over into Git. So then it can be pulled off by somebody else. Now, in this case, I'm going to, so that's kind of the first phase of getting these properties on the model. The next step would be to then go and pull the model into a Jupyter notebook environment. I'm using here a SimCenter Studio, which is basically a managed Jupyter Labs type of environment, and it has a Jupyter Labs extension to Git. So I'm actually able to then to pull the models down. When I get changes, they show up here and I pull them down. There's similar setups for Jupyter Labs, and you can set it, you can create an extension if you want to use a completely open source solution. I will be showing later using a notebook from the SM Capella side when I launch it. So anyway, this is an option you can do. What it ends up doing is creating a file structure here, and the file structure in this browser window, you can see that I have the file structure of all the projects that I have. Here's the one for the trail power. As I navigate down to it, what I've done is I've created a notebook folder. And inside that notebook folder, I created this one called Power Study. So that's what we're looking at here. So the Power Study is the notebook I created. We'll walk through the cells in the notebook to kind of show you what's there. You can have textual content. Then you can go ahead and import the Capella MBSE library. And with that Capella MBSE library, you can use it to basically load up the .ard file, which it uses, along with other files that are in the same directory area. In this case, I'm actually pulling a static JPEG image that I saved from the system model, and I'm displaying it. So you can see here's the system model with all the content. So I'm displaying that. The next thing I do is I go in, I load up all the parameters that are on the logical architecture. And basically I'm searching and getting all the functional parameters and then all the component parameters. And I display their values. So I get kind of a list of all the properties that I have available. So this makes me have something that I can work with. I even have in this example here, the code that you would use to then pull the property out by name. So there's the code. And this is kind of an example right here where I'm just doing a print statement and of battery size. And I'm going and pulling the information on the battery in this string here. To get the battery size and its units, so I can get that. So it's a very simple way of just getting the data out of the model. I then prepare to do some analysis, so I import what I'm going to be using for that, of various Python libraries, NumPy, SymPy, Pandas, some of the things I'm going to use for my analysis. I do a symbolic model actually first. The symbolic model is going to generate a pulse train, so I have examples here. Now, pretty much everything that I've done with this model, I used ChatGPT to help me create these concepts of pulse trains and used it to just as an expert sitting on the side asking questions from, because I'm not a Python guy. I didn't learn Python early in my career. Learned pretty much all of it by using either searching Google for it, but now I've found that ChatGPT just blows it away. There's so much knowledge. And also ChatGPT even knows this Capella MBSE library, which is surprising. It's not perfect, you know, there's flaws, but it's as perfect as you would have if you had an associate sitting next to you and they were giving you answers. So it's pretty decent from that perspective. So then what I do again in the code, I had some library stuff set up. I go in and I actually load up all the values that I care about. So here I'm loading the values up, finding the logical components, their names, I'm getting the property values off of them and pulling them into the model. And then I'm displaying those. So I use a markdown display capability where I can load them up. So this shows here the sun period, load period, boost efficiency, and the formulas I'm going to use. So I'm going to do the power generation formula. There's the battery load. And then basically the battery charge. So I basically, you know, I'm showing what the load is on it and then the battery charge. And both of them are using a pulse drain. So you're going to see that in the results. In the study, then I look at the various configurations. So I basically look at the battery count and panel count, and I change those as I go through the study. And this is the code here that will actually go and do that change and generate the reports. And this is what it looks like then. I have study configuration one, and I show panel count as two, battery count as two. This is the solar panel power and the battery capacity. And then I plot here the power produced. Here I'm plotting the power desired versus what is delivered. The desired is what, you know, basically is what the USB device wants to have. The delivered is what is possible because of the charge that's in the battery. This is the power produced and consumed over time. And then this is the battery charge. And as you can see here, the battery is being depleted. So this is not a good example, a good run of what you would see. And then I basically then even do a correlation. I do a Kendall-Taus correlation. It's in the code that basically checks to see how good these lines here match up for this power desired and delivered. And you can see this one's not a very good matchup. Therefore, the score is pretty low, 0.64 with the Kendall-Tau analysis. I do this for all the different combinations, and you can see the diagrams that I get out of it as things start getting better when I start getting a higher power. So here's three panels and I got two batteries. It starts to align pretty good. I'm getting now an alignment between the desired and the power desired and power deliver. You got to remember I'm basically draining the battery with a pulse rate of about 25% of the day. So 25% of the day power is being pulled from the charger, and it's only being charged for half the day. So this one here is starting to look a little better. You can see the battery is only slightly depleted over a certain period of time, which would probably be almost a borderline acceptable solution with three panels. But then as I go into the later parts of the study, you can see that I'm getting a better results with it as it goes through. Here's more outputs. Show the rest of the outputs. And there's study six. And eventually I get all the way up to the last one, which is basically a four battery, four panel count. And you can see here, I'm basically only during the initial charging up of the battery do we have a mismatch, but then it stays fine over time with the battery charge. And you can see that same thing here is that they line up pretty well with a tau basically of 0.95. So shows that those models there with the higher battery, the higher panel count really are a decent solution that could be used. So anyway, just kind of, and then finally at the end, I just put a manual update of what the summary was from the results. So this basically shows that a four solar panel and at least three batteries will meet desired need. So that's an example of what you can do. Again, running this is pretty cool. You just push the button to run it. It'll restart it. You'll see it clear out the model, and then it'll go through and start running the results. So response is pretty good. Once this is done, you take the model and use get a functionality here to publish the model back. So I basically would go back to the get view. It'll tell me what's been changed in the file. And then basically I'm able to shove that, push it back in. It'll basically put it into the changes. This certain example here is shows that I've changed the model. I can just basically add the changes and then do a command operation and put it back to get. Once that's done, I can then go back to the Capella model and do an operation to download it. So we can go back here and I can go to the trail power and I can go again to Teams. And in this case, I'll do a pull operation and it's going to pull the information that down into here. And by the way, it'll pull the power study. So here's the power study in the notebooks folder right there. If you do a setup to open with to Jupyter Notebook, in this case, it's already been set up. I set it up previously. You can then double click on the connection here and it will go ahead and launch a Jupyter Notebook. And that's what it's doing. It'll launch the Jupyter Notebook window, which kind of runs on its own server. And then we'll load up the study here. So the study is loaded up, so I can see it in a Jupyter notebook view. And again, I can hit the button here and run the study now from basically the Capella model, which is really kind of cool that I can run it from here. So you could have multiple people kind of working on this. Somebody with maybe more of a simulation expertise could do the simulation and then use Git as a way to go back and forth between the two. So anyway, that's kind of what I wanted to show you in this, kind of summarizing then what we did in this exercise is we created the system model and we created and populated properties. We published a model to GitHub. Then we created a simulation notebook that accesses the model content. We ran the notebook. They published the notebook to GitHub once it's been done. And then we can bring the back the model into the system model from GitHub and then launch the notebook from Capella. That's basically it. If you want to go and play around with this particular example, it's been published up onto the GitHub site. I actually was using that GitHub site. It's located right here for it as I was developing it. So go ahead and download it and give it a try. Please subscribe and share. Your interests make a difference on the future topics. So let me know if this was helpful and you enjoyed it. Thank you.